their name.
You better set up the MPGR or these dudes are about to roll up on you.
Do you know what Aklo's Twitter profile, what his Twitter bio is?
No.
His Twitter bio is, I one time beat Armada in HBox in a 2v1, but it was off stream. And then it says, number one in Long Island, probably number one in the world.
Yeah, actually now I remember that.
Yeah.
All right, well, he's looking like he's number one on rollback right now, because he almost earned a Death Ginger there. Oh, yeah, he knows that off that weak back air, he's going to be a tech chase situation. That's super great cognizance from Aklo.
Yeah, good pickup by Ginger, too. But I agree, off the weak back air to immediately go in the dash dance because he knows that he's going to have a tech chase after. Smart stuff.
Yeah, because, you know, these days, people are spamming ASDI down, so after you do that weak back air, you're not even... Oh, JC Shine almost finishes the stock!
Oh my god!
Man, moments like that get me pissed about Randall. Like, because if Randall's not there, Aklo actually kills him.
Yeah, because he just gets to shine him after the up air.
After the dash, JC.
Oh, shine. After the shine, I see.
Yeah, yeah. Like, wait, okay, but.
Well, Randall... never mind. We didn't mean it, Randall.
Yeah, yeah. Mind that, Randall. Randall, give it the. Wait, dude, Randall's.
Oh, he is getting involved, dude.
What is this match?
What is Aklo doing? Oh, I like the baby sit there into the laser.
Yeah, oh, I thought he was gonna. I thought he was gonna go all in. Oh, beautiful, beautiful tech side beat.
Yeah.
Oh, that's like the best recovery you can do, actually.
Oh, he almost had him. What?
And man, that was honestly an impressive game, all things considered. Like, I feel like Randall made the game seem uglier than it really was. I actually think a lot of what they did was really well executed.
Yeah. There was it was a mix of both. I hear what you're saying. It was still some pretty impressive high level technical stuff.
Yeah, Randall's involvement was a little out of hand that game.
Mm-hmm. But we're going back. We're giving him an opportunity to get in the mix again. Oh, down throw
That's an awesome down throw up tilt. So yeah. Good. Like, as Falco, you're happy to... What?
Okay. Grab release. It was grab release, and then Ginger was daring down because he was trying to hold down. He ran off the stage and got a grab release. Yeah.
Interesting. Usually you see that with Falco's laser when it hits. Oh, that's so good. I love that weak back air. You know, and if you're Aklo, you have to DI that out. Down and away. Like, the moment that you DI that in... Shy Guys help out Aklo so much on that edge guard, by the way, because they just add hit lag to the side B.
Oh, Ginger's moving, dude.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay, Aklo gets to ledge. Phantom Shine.
Oh.
Bear?
Yeah. Wow, that was insane. Took him across the entire level and pretty much finished him. It was almost like a zero to death.
Yeah. Okay, what can Aklo do here? Doesn't get the punish, so he just tries to keep Ginger pinned, but Full Hop gets him out. Okay.
I love that. Yeah, he predicted the double jump down air, but Ginger makes it back.
Sometimes you just gotta roll.
Up smash.
Yeah.
You can't go, like, cleanly above Fox, that's just making it free.
Well, and you saw that Aklo shielded on reaction to the side B, so he was pretty set either way.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That last hit of drill forcing Ginger off was very good for Aklo.
For sure. Oh, beautiful angle. Shout out to Nez.
Oh, I like that from Ginger a lot. Because he knows that the up throw is going to put Fox into actually, like, pretty fast action ability.
Mm-hmm. Uncharacteristic for Aklo to drop this.
I agree.
Yeah, that could definitely affect the outcome of his tournament. The fact that he missed that kill, we'll see.
Oh, no jump! Yeah.
Wow, that was like a max range up tilt, and I mean up air, and it was a single hit up air nonetheless. So no counterplay available to Ginger.
Yeah, good stuff.
But now, fun fact: the first up air is not going to tumble because it's stale. That being said, he does hit a few more afterward, and those will most certainly tumble.
Oh, man. Oh, the reverses with the up smash. Was that intentional?
Down smash. It's over. Was what intentional?
The reverse with the up smash? No, there's no way. I'm just trying to think why Ginger would up smash otherwise. Huh. Because that up smash really put Aklo in an awkward position afterwards.
Falco's up smash for like anti-air purposes is really interesting. Like when Falco needs to anti-air like in front of him as well as close some distance, it's actually like the optimal choice because up tilt you can only turn around in place with, but up smash you can dash forward JC and so you'll advance forward a little bit.
Yeah, I got you.
And you can get some, you can get like a really favorable tumble. Like, you know, not like the strong hit of the up smash, but more like the sour spot.
Yeah, which is what Ginger got right there, too.
Exactly.
I do think it was probably a missed up tilt, but it worked out for him. So, you know,
yeah,
we'll say it was intentional. Okay. Aklo's got a big comeback to make, and he goes to Stadium. I typically think of this as a really good Falco stage, so interesting. All right.
Yeah.
Never mind.
And that double hit forward air was actually the best choice. That was the only thing he could have done to get Ginger off stage in that situation.
He just held Shine and then wave dash back as soon as Ginger came in. That was so funny. Aklo can be down 2-0, and he will still do Aklo things, no matter what.
Really nice for Aklo to smash DI that first hit up air away. Mm-hmm. He saw that Ginger was trying to go for the first hit up air into a shine.
Oh, Ginger a little late on the dare there. Okay. Forward smash.
Yeah, and
he's gonna die from shine. Yep.
Yeah, that's the classic. You just shine him, and the game's countdown for like horizontal knockback is still very high in the middle of that tech. In the middle of that tech roll.
Yeah, that was momentum stacking. That was sick.
Yeah. It's a more common situation than you'd think against Falco. Oh, that's a bad side B. He's lucky he didn't get down here.
Ooh. Ginger really keeping Aklo locked down with these lasers. Takes the jump.
No double jump, but a great angle.
Tries to set up a tech chase. Dare, yeah.
Damn, you know, it was so smart. Ginger actually waited. Like, he let Aklo follow the knockback vector for, like, a little longer. He didn't down air him early. He waited until...
Oh, yeah, till he was over, till it would send him off stage for sure.
Yeah.
Okay,
that was smart. Dude, that was smart. Like, that could have gone into something for sure.
Yeah. Ginger has been choosing to dare with these combos instead of sending Aklo off stage early, and I think it's been paying off for him a lot of the time. It's definitely a risky mix-up, but it's been getting him the percent he needs to really close things out. Oh boy.
Ginger swoops underneath, he's going to finish it. That's it, Genesis 4. Genesis 4.
That's it.
Yeah. All right, Aklo's run is over. Dominant showing from Ginger.
Yeah, truly dominant. Hey, I said earlier that I wanted to see Ginger versus Moki again, and we're going to get that.
Yeah, it looks like the two pros ended up outdoing the hometown heroes at the end of the day. But man, what a great showing from Aklo and JMook.